She looks a lot better.
It's only the soma. We'll get her to tonight.
I hope we will.
Yeah. Do you think one of us should stand guard? Just in case.
In case of what?
Don't play Norris to me. In case the hounds return. In case top police finds us. In case warplanes start flying towards us. In case of danger. You need to go on?
No, I can think ahead. But I'm not to stand guard alone. You're coming along with.
But what about her?
She'll be fine for tonight at least. The others are here in case anything actually happens.
Do not worry yourself. We will watch over this wounded soul.
Okay. Let us go then.
Come on. Make your cigarette?
You don't have any black magic stuff, do you?
No, I don't care enough for tobacco to attempt squandering a black market pack of cigarette. Always have some black market tea, though.
We'll refuse that offer. Thank you. So, what's your story? Where do you come from? And how did you ever meet our dear friend Montag?
It's a deceivingly simple story, actually. I'm a war veteran. He was my neighbor. I took a perhaps unhealthy interest into his affairs. I thought him to be unusual, at the very least. After the nuke, I wandered on the outskirts of the city in a sort of journey of self-discovery, if you will. Shortly after, I found this drum in a heap of garbage, and now here we are.
A modern war veteran, are you?
That's right. Modern warfare is just a death job by now. No boot camp, no training. Just dealing with all the disputes involved around the disputed areas. That and finding useless ways to concentrate their energies into warfare prediction without ever making any really use of it. We have enough bombs and firepower to make the planet explode 10 times over and then some.
Do you like your job?
As strange as it sounds, yes. I found I was making the world a better place.
And how, exactly?
Think of it like this. Our society is comprised into 3 main classes. The inner party, the outer party, and the proletariat. Now, the pros are further divided into 3 subclasses, but that's not important for now. Those classes function based on a scale of wealth. See, with all our technological improvements, we'd have the possibility to distribute wealth around the world. But what happens if we choose to do that? What happens when everyone is rich, healthy, and happy?
We lose our lower working class.
Exactly. So it becomes the mission of the people on top to make sure that the people on the bottom stay there. For without them, society collapses. In order to do so, we must control the distribution of wealth. One way to do so is warfare. By putting all of our energies into producing rockets and tanks and whatnot, all the state's extra resources are wasted.
You heard that?
It was the wind. Nothing to worry about. So, tell me, what is your story? Who were you in your past life?
I was an alpha doctor.
An alpha caste doctor? Or doctor for alpha caste people?
An alpha caste doctor. I was the assistant to director at the Hatcherine Conditioning Center. Genetics, DNA, the canting people. That could not have been the win. It was definitely something else.
If you're a doctor, you shouldn't be here sitting with me. You should be by her side.
But you said that...
Go! A woman's hand is in your... A woman's life is in your hand. I'll stand guard. Now get out of here!
Destruction to all protection for the benefit of the nation or its destruction. Power.
grade.
At 9 in the morning, Mildred was not in bed. Montag stood up quickly, answered promptly, and ran out of the hall to stop the little big door. She had both ears plugged with electronic bees that were humming the hour away. She looked up silently, saw him, and nodded.
You all right?
She was an expert at lip reading from 10 years of apprenticeship at Seashell Ear Timbals. She nodded again. Montag sat down.
I had the best summer vacation last night.
Last night?
I slept so well. I'm starving, but I feel great. Ford, this is great.
Last night.
What about last night?
Don't you remember?
What? Did we have a wild party or something? I feel like I haven't eaten in years. Who was there?
A few people.
That's what I thought. I hope I didn't do anything foolish at the party.
No.
You don't look so hot yourself.
In the late afternoon, the entire world was dark gray. Montag stood up, putting on his badge with the orange salamander burning across it. He looked up at the air conditioning vent for a long time. His wife, in the telescreen collar, waited up long enough to look up.
Hey, the man's thinking!
Yes, Mildred. I wanted to talk to you about last night. You downed the pill bottle.
Oh, I wouldn't do that.
Mildred, the bottle was empty.
I wouldn't do a thing like that. Why would I do a thing like that?
I don't know. Maybe you took two, forgot, took two more. Forgot again and took two more. And then you didn't stop until you had a dozen of them in you. Huh? Maybe.
Heck, what would I want to go and do a silly thing like that for?
I told you, I don't know, Mildred.
I did not do that. Never in a billion years.
All right. If you say so. What's on this afternoon?
Oh, well, this is a play that comes on the wall-to-wall circuit in 10 minutes. They mailed me my part this morning. They write the script with this one part missing. It's a new idea. The homemaker, that's me, it's the missing part. And when it comes time for the missing lines, they all look at me out of the three walls and I say the lines. Here, for instance, when the man says, "My spoon is too big," and he looks at me, sitting here, center stage, see? And I say, "I am a banana." And then they go on with the play until he says, "Tuesday's coming. Did you bring your coat?" And then I say, "I live in a giant bucket." Isn't this fun, Guy? It sure is fun.
But what's the play about?
I just told you. There are these people named Bob and Ruth and Helen.
Oh.
It sure is fun. And it will be even more fun when we can afford to have the fourth wall installed. How long you figure before we save up, torn down that wall and have a fourth telescreen put in? You know it's only $20,000.
Mildred, it's one third of my yearly pay.
It's only $20,000, and I should think you'd consider me sometimes. Why, if we had a fourth wall, it'd be just like this room wasn't ours at all, but all kind of exotic people's rooms. We could do without a few things.
Mildred, I'm sorry, but we're already doing without a few things to pay for the third wall. It was put in just 2 months ago. Don't you remember?
Is that all it was? Oh. Well, goodbye, dear.
Goodbye. Does it have a happy ending?
I haven't read that far.
What are you up to now?
I'm still crazy. The rain feels good. I loved walking it.
I don't think I'd like that.
Maybe you would if you tried.
I never have.
Rain even tastes good.
What do you do? Go trying everything once?
Sometimes twice.
Hey, what you got there?
I thought it was the last of the sunflowers, but, well, it isn't. I didn't think I'd find one in the lawn this late. Have you ever heard of rubbing it under your chin? Like this. Look!
Why?
If it rubs off, it means I'm in love. Well, has it?
You're yellow under there.
Woo! Yeah! Let's try you now.
No, it won't work on me.
Yeah.
Please.
Come on!
Well?
What a shame! You're not in love with anyone!
Yes, I am!
It doesn't show!
Of course I am! I am very much in love! I am!
Please don't look that way!
It's the sunflowers! You've used it all up on yourself! That's why it won't work on me!
Oh, of course! Of course, that must be it! I'm sorry, I really am. I didn't want to make you angry like this.
I'm not angry. Upset, yes.
Well, I've got to be going, so say forgive me, okay? I got to see a psychiatrist now. You know, they make me do it. I think of all these things to say. I don't know what my psychiatrist thinks of me. He says I'm a regular onion, so I keep him busy peeling away the layers.
I'm inclined to believe you need a psychiatrist.
I second that motion.
You don't really mean that!
No, I don't really mean that.
They want to know why I go out at night and hike in forests and collect butterflies and watch birds and write a journal. I'll show you my collection sometime.
Good.
But not my journal, of course.
Why not?
They want to know what I do with my free time.
You're changing the subject, as usual.
Sometimes I tell them I like to sit and think, but I don't tell them what. I've got them running. And sometimes I tell them that some people never go crazy, what truly horrible lives they must lead. And I tell them also that I like to throw my head back like this and let the rain fall in my mouth. Ah, it tastes just like wine. Have you ever tried it?
Nope.
You have forgiven me, haven't you?
Yes. Yes, I have. Ford knows why. You're peculiar. You're aggravating. Yet, you're easy to forgive.
You're peculiar yourself, Mr. Montag. Sometimes I even forget you're a fireman. Now, may I make you angry once again?
Go ahead.
How did it start? How did you, Montag, get into it? You're not like the others. I've seen a few. I know. When I talk to you, you look at me. When I said something about the sky last night, you looked up at the sky. The others would never do that. They would just leave me there talking, or even threaten me. You know, no one has time for anyone else anymore. Did you notice that? You're one of the few, yeah? That's why I find it so strange you're a fireman. It just doesn't seem right for you somehow.
You'd better run off to your appointment.
Montag! Listen!
What's there to listen?
Just shh! Choose a word! Just choose a word!
Fire?
Did you hear that?
Echo.
The echo. Like a silent raindrop falling.
It's the sound of
silence.
And she ran off, letting him stand alone in the rain. He stood there for a very long time, only then, very slowly, he tilted his head back in the rain and opened his mouth.
So, bye!